Pharmacogenetics gives us the possibility to go to the roots and find out why certain drugs have side effects. And by finding out those factors, we can actually prevent that patients get drugs that are not perfect for them.
What I really want is to achieve that everyone has the possibility of getting medication which is appropriate for their body. That has been a very big advance in health because of the drugs. But now we are at a point in the development of technology that it is possible to see what is ongoing in our genes. And it's time, I think, to put that information to the doctors in order to give me a better medication.
It's the implementation is the point that we're currently focusing on, and that's going extremely well. It's the only country where you can go with your DNA information, considering pharmacogenetics, to any pharmacist, and the pharmacist will be able to tell you what is the dose for particular drugs that you should take. In our country, you will have an outcome within a couple of days or maximum 1 to 2 weeks. You can get the reliable results fast, and you can act upon it.
We are amongst the few countries in continental Europe where the implementation of pharmacogenetics is part of the government program. So the government pledged 2 years ago to implement pharmacogenetics for polypharmacy and oncology as the two starting areas, and from there move further.
The state of Qatar has invested in the last 20 years developing research that has led to the understanding also of the specific genetic architecture of the people living in those countries. In the space of pharmacogenomics, I should say that we have engaged down the path of bringing tools that are DNA-based for providing assistance in diagnostics.
There are still challenges that we have to face. Awareness of the clinician that it's indeed possible to have this kind of testing. Awareness that there are those recommendations, so it's not a test without any actionability, but you can do something about it.
Even though that pharmacogenetic information can be found in the product specifics of the drugs, the insurance system is reluctant to pay for the analysis. Something very, very challenging circles around on the knowledge that physicians have of how to implement pharmacogenetics into their daily life. Educating physicians is the way to go. This is something that we need to do. However, it's way too slow for the implementation. The other thing that needs to be done is to make reports as obvious and easy to handle as possible.
The challenges that we will face in a country such as Qatar are no different from what you could find elsewhere. The physicians in Qatar are quite knowledgeable of the potential of the technologies. What I believe is a bit of a challenge is to be able to integrate these in the general practice, in the day-to-day practice. It is more a matter of actually conveying to the public that the tools are now available and the national health system can implement it.
I think it's very important to have an interaction to learn from each other what are the challenges and also learn what are the solutions that were found in the different countries. We try to bring together people to exchange information. The whole idea is to present pharmacogenetics and pharmacogenomics in such a way that you're not overpromising, but also you will allow patients and clinicians to benefit from the potential that it really has.
Easy to use reporting is the most pragmatic and fastest way to implement pharmacogenetics.
The test is going to deliver the information about the drugs related to the illness of the patient, polypharmacy patients. That is where the complexity becomes too big to be handled in the short time and in an effective way. All that has also impact on the cost, and it's difficult. If the doctor gets a very nice report, he can read, he can understand, and can apply to that patient at that moment, then is the acceptance going to be very good. The most difficult thing will be the interpretation. And in this interpretation, we need to put efforts together, all scientific people, also the companies who are doing work on that, and get to a standardization. My company is in Germany, in Fürth. We began and work with scientific papers. We are querying the information ourselves, and we went with this information to the doctors. We were not using the words doctors are using. We made the work to translate that from the scientific way to the doctor's language. And now our doctors are using that, and they are very happy.
Three areas which I think are very important currently: psychiatry, oncology, and pain medication. I think we have a big contribution in psychiatry. For psychiatry, it's very difficult to estimate whether the drug is working or not, and people suffer from side effects. And to make sure that they do not suffer in vain from these side effects, it's good to have pharmacogenetics up front. The second area, I would like to mention oncology. Oncology is, of course, very important as well, because most of the drugs there are given to a level as high as much as possible to ensure a proper therapy. Failure of therapy you don't want to have, but toxicity is usually also dose limiting. The third area, which is very much important, is pain. It's only ethical that we establish upfront whether you will benefit from a pain-killing therapy instead of using trial and error that we're currently using.
The main therapeutic areas, it's psychiatry, I would say, it's internal medicine, it's oncology. However, there is one area that I think is extremely important, and that's the area of polypharmacy. The older a person grows, the more likely is the chance to end up with a whole list of drugs. Our champion had 43 drugs, but everything beyond 4 to 5 drugs, there are so many drug interactions that come in the play then as well. Those based on the genetics of that specific person makes it very challenging to find the right mix of drugs that is right for that specific person. Polypharmacy is going to be the most difficult area in order to educate physicians in how to cope and how to adjust the dosing and the prescription based on the pharmacogenetic report so that we can guarantee a safe situation for the patient.
If you have this one patient in front of you suffering from these side effects, you order a pharmacogenetic test and you can indeed see that the side effects are indeed explained by the pharmacogenetic information. Those clinicians, they adopt pharmacogenetics much faster because they realize they have more patients that may suffer from the same problems. And then we see the transition from ordering the test when there are side effects to ordering the test prior for start of certain therapies.
Technology providers as Illumina had shown the way in many ways already. Beyond DNA-based technologies, there may be other omic technologies which would be useful.
That we are at the beginning of that era, which it will be possible for everyone to have the power, the empowerment to decide on their own health. And the doctors will gain a complete different role. They will be given orientation, but the responsibility on our own health is going to be our own.